Get your SISM training from Thor Peterson.
We are going throughout this course to talk about NIST special publications. Right now, we're going to look at 800-53 Revision 4. Revision 5 is being worked on, but since this exam was not updated before it was out, you will not be tested on Revision 5. All of the NIST documents are made by the U.S. National Institute of Standards and Technologies, NIST, and it is free to download. So either you can go to the link I have here, or you can get it from the download section at the end of this domain. It is definitely something that I recommend downloading and something that I recommend downloading now. If you remember back to 2018, 2019, I know, a long time ago, the US government shut down, and with that, the NIST website was taken down, meaning I would get 5-10 emails every day asking if I could send them the NIST publications because they were no longer available. So, download them now. The full length of the document can be a little daunting. It is 462 pages, but the important parts are less than 100. And of those, you really just need the highlights, at least for this certification. Revision 4 was published in April of 2013 and updated in January of 2015. The full name of NIST Special Publication 800-53 Revision 4 is Security and Private Controls for Federal Information Systems and Organizations, meaning this is a standard that any federal organization needs to adhere to. And not just federal organizations, but any business that wants to do business with them, they also need to follow it. And it is free knowledge. And the reason why the NIST publications are so popular, even if we're not in the government sector or we do business with them, they have spent a ton of time and a ton of money developing these really solid standards that we can then tailor to our needs. If we as an organization need to implement security and privacy controls, why would we want to spend years and millions of dollars developing them when someone else already has done it for us? This is probably a better product than we could make. And a shift we're seeing with the NIST publications is they're going more broad. Remember, Revision 4 was federal information systems. That is going to be removed in Revision 5. It's just going to be security and privacy controls. If you look over here on the right, you can see they use a three-tiered system. Tier 1 is the organization. Tier 2 is the mission and business processes. And then Tier 3 is our information systems. Whereas the top of the pyramid has the strategic risk, the bottom have the tactical risk. And all this ties back to everything we've talked about already. Very oversimplified, the organization in Tier 1 is where senior management and the board of directors decide what is important for us. We talked about this when we covered the mission, the vision, and the ethics we have, and with that, we use it to build Tier 2. Everything we do in Tier 2 is based off what senior management has decided in Tier 1. We establish our security categories, or the security tiers that we have, and our enterprise architecture. We then use everything from Tier 2 in Tier 3, and then we break Tier 3 down even further. In Tier 3, we use a six-step process, and in this publication, NIST 800-53, we only focus on Step 2, security controls. As you can see, there are other special publications that focus on the other steps. So when we choose to implement something from any of the NIST publications, we can use tailoring or scoping. And that is really why they are so widely used. They're in such great detail, and we can pick the parts that will work for us. With this one, we can go in and look at the security controls, which are organized into 18 families. And then each of those 18 families have different security controls that we can use on different systems. The first one here, for instance, is access control. You can then drill even further into each of the controls for each family. So let's continue with access control. just scroll down here. And if we look at the first two controls, AC1 and AC2, you can see right here, the baselines are divided into low, moderate, and high. So with AC1, access control policies and procedures, regardless if we're looking at low, moderate, or high, we would implement AC1. But if we look at account management, AC2, you can see on low, we would only implement AC2 as the baseline. If it is moderate, then we implement the baseline plus 4 security controls. If it is high, we implement the baseline, the same 4, and then we also implement security controls 5, 11, 12, and 13. Let's scroll a little further down and look at those controls. We looked at AC2-4. That's account management, automated audit actions. So for our moderates and our highs, we would implement that and then drill even further down into that one control and see account management and automated audit actions has the information system automatically audits account creation, modification, enabling, disabling, and removing actions, and then it notifies whomever in the organization is defined as the personnel that needs to be told or the roles that need to be told. And then on top of that, it also has a list of related controls. And while this might seem overwhelming and daunting, you also know how to use good project management skills. You understand that each task can be broken down into smaller and smaller, more manageable work packages, just like you do with your studying. Don't try to do everything at once. Do one thing at a time. But just imagine how crazy this would be if you had to start from scratch. So be very thankful that someone else has done a great job for you. Another thing that I think is important to mention here, take a look at the glossary in Appendix B. It has some pretty good definitions and straightforward answers to what a cyber attack is or cybersecurity. And then on top of that, it also has great references like any good publication should. Where did we get this definition from? So the actual parts of the document that you might need to understand for the exam is less than 50 pages. And from that, you still only need the highlights. And I'm going to repeat myself here, download it now. You don't know when you need it and the government in the US has shut down. So when you need them and the government is no longer functioning, then thank you, past you, and thank you, Thor. And with that, we're done with NIST 800-53. If you liked the video, please leave a thumbs up and remember to subscribe to the channel. To get my courses and the free study materials, click on Learn More. Thank you, and I will see you in the next video.